why fundamentals of criminal investigation as a subject or one of the subject of the criminal detection and investigation is important, or ito yung para sa akin ang pinaka-importanting subject na under sa criminal detection and investigation. So simple, from the word fundamentals, nandito yung pinaka-root or pinaka-ugat ng criminal detection and investigation. Why? Dito yung pinaka-basic at yung mga primary principles at concepts ng investigation. So we cannot proceed to other subjects when dili na to or hindi natin ma-master itong fundamentals of criminal investigation. So let me give you some quotes from Bruce Lee, a well-known martial artist sa history, di ba? So ito yung quotes, yung words niya sa kanyang quotes. I fear not the man who has practiced 10,000 kicks once, but I fear the man who has practiced one kick 10,000 times. So ano yung ang pinahihiwatig niya sa words na ito or principles na ito? So, simple. Before you can proceed in advance sa mga advance na mga idea or information, so kailangan i-master niyo muna yung fundamentals. So same sa subject natin ngayon, kung hindi natin ma-master yung fundamentals of criminal investigation, so we cannot proceed to other subjects, di ba? So huwag niyong kalimutan ang basic. Ito lang yung pinaiwatig or yung gustong sabihin ni Bruce Lee, di ba? Kasi you cannot proceed in advance without knowing the fundamentals, di ba? So ito yung principles ni Bruce Lee. So okay, let's proceed to the investigation. Criminal detection and investigation, the fundamentals of criminal investigation. So when we talk about investigation, it is an inquiry or judicial or otherwise for the discovery and collection of facts concerning the matters involved. So when we talk about investigation, it is the general term, di ba? So kung lalabas ito sa board exam at ito yung questions or ito yung question na ibinigay at may 4 items na pagpipilian kung may criminal investigation doon, so simple ang i-choose nyo is itong investigation kasi more on general definition ito ng investigation, not specific, di ba? The word investigation came from the Latin word vestigere, which means to track or to trace. So, ito yung dito nanggaling ang word na investigation. To track or to trace. So, the term criminal investigator. What do you mean by criminal investigator? It is a public safety officer who is tasked, di ba, to conduct the investigation of all criminal cases as provided for and embodied under revised penal code. So, when we talk about criminal investigator, ito yung mga tao, di ba? Mga tao na nagkakandak ng investigation. Simple. Simply, di ba? Custodial investigation, investigation conducted by law enforcement officer after a person has been arrested or deprived of his freedom of action. So when we talk about custodial investigation, naka-specified naman ito. So under the custody of the law enforcement officer, so yan yung custodial investigation. meaning na aris na yung tao o yung suspect sa crime na ginawa niya, di ba? Once the person is arrested, so siyempre ang freedom of action niya o yung freedom niya under the constitution is deprived. So yan yung sa custodial investigation na, di ba? Ano tong neighborhood investigation? So, neighborhood investigation is one of the most crucial steps in kidnap ransom cases, which is often overlooked. Diba? The objective is to identify. Diba? Ang objective nitong neighborhood investigation is to identify and interview in person all individuals in the area. Diba? Where the victim was kidnapped. So, when we talk about neighborhood investigation, ito yung pag-iimbestiga mga taong na-involved or posibleng na-involved sa kidnap for ransom cases. So, ito yung neighborhood investigation. O, posibleng na-involved, kung sabihin natin posibleng na-involved, ito yung mga taong nakasalimuwa or na-encounter ng kidnap victim before siya na-kidnap. So, crime scene. We all know about the crime scene, di ba? Ito yung venue or place where the crime incident is happened. So, ito yung crime scene or area wherein lahat ng elements ng crime ay na-commit ng suspect, di ba? So, the term corpus delicti used to describe the physical or material evidence that a crime has been committed. So, when we talk about corpus delicti, ito yung one of the kinds of physical evidence. Diba? Corpus delicti. So, sa physical evidence, when we talk about physical evidence, ito yung ebidensya na nakita mismo sa crime scene. So, corpus delicti is another term is the body of the crime. So, itong corpus delicti is a Latin term of the body of the crime. For example nito is yung sa murder. For example, the crime of murder. So, ang corpus delicti is yung corpse or yung body ng tao na nakita mismo napatay, di ba? Ito yung dead body. So, sa murder, ang corpus delicti is yung dead body. It is one of the elements of the murder, di ba? Confession, it is an express acknowledgement by the accused in a criminal prosecution of the truth of his guilt, di ba? So, kabaliktaran nito, inversely, ang admission refers to a statement of facts not directly constituting an acknowledgement of guilt. So, when we talk about admission, so, before we proceed to another term, what is the difference between confession and admission? So, when we talk about confession, ina-acknowledge niya directly that he committed the crime. So, ang suspect ina-acknowledge directly na siya yung nag-commit talaga ng crime. While yung admission, acknowledge siya. Diba? Acknowledge or sinabi niya na nandoon siya mismo sa crime or diba? Refers to the statement of facts not directly constituting an acknowledgement of guilt. Meaning, acknowledge niya na totoo yung facts at circumstances but he is not directly acknowledging his guilt na hindi siya mismo yung nagpatay or nag-commit ng crime. So, ito yung difference between confession and admission. So, the next term is the physical evidence. When we talk about physical evidence, may tatlong klase or kinds of physical evidence. Ito yung corpus delicti na sinabi ko kanina. Then the associative evidence, then the tracing evidence. So para hindi kayo, hindi nyo makalimutan, inurize nyo lang yung word or yung letters na cut or cut. When you talk about physical evidence, may cut, C-E-T, corpus delicti, associated at tracing evidence. So when we talk about physical evidence, evidence that addresses to the senses of the court. Ano tong senses of the court? When we talk about senses of the court, ito yung it indicates the five senses. So ito yung nag-address sa five senses. Makikita niya mismo, maaamoy niya, maririnig. So nahahawakan mismo. So physical meaning may object talaga na kita or naririnig. So ito yung physical evidence. So we proceed to victimology or the victim profiling. A detailed account of the victim's lifestyle and personality assists in determining nature of the disappearance, the risk level of the victim, and the type of the person who could have committed the crime. So when we talk about victimology, ito yung study ng victims or pinoprofile yung victim, yung detailed account sa kanyang lifestyle or personality, o sino yung the risk level of the victim to commit suicide, di ba? So it involves the study of the victim itself. So for your information, hindi lang po sa criminology or sa criminology na course, hindi lang tayo nagfo-focus sa suspect, pati na rin yung mga victim mismo. Why? Bakit hindi lang sa suspect? Simply because victims, kung walang victim, so wala rin suspect. So we should also try to study the behavior of the victim, his lifestyle or personality. So it will contribute to investigation. So malalaman natin sino yung nakalink na suspect sa kanya through studying his lifestyle and personality. So ito yung victimology or victim profiling. Next is the waterboarding. Ano itong term na waterboarding? Refers to the practice of strapping a suspect to a board with his or her lowered. Diba? So more on punishment. Ito yung torture or punishment na linalagyan ng tubig ang ulo ng isang tao so that mahirapan siyang huminga. Diba? Ito yung waterboarding. So, Chinese water torture, one of in the interrogation technique din na ginagamit nung una in order for the suspect to admit or confess of the crime. Nung una yun. Pero ngayon, hindi natin ginagamit to kasi may law na nagbabawal na gamitin natin itong mga torture, no, mga interrogation techniques na ito. So, bawal na ito ngayon. Then, the term serial killer. We talk about serial killer. Ito yung kung sa Tagalog pa, mamamatay tao, diba? Is someone who murders three or more persons with cooling off periods in between. So, ito yung serial killer. Actos reos. Ano tong actos reos? di ba? Or the guilty act. Proof that a criminal act has occurred. Meaning, ang action talaga ay na-commit o nag-o-occur. Diba? So, other term nitong actus reus is the guilty act. Ano itong rogues gallery? Is a police collection of pictures or photographs of criminals and suspects kept for identification purposes. So, ito yung rogues gallery. Nandito yung mga pictures ng mga criminals, syndicates, at mga modus operandi nila. So, ito yung rogues gallery. Ito yung ginagamit sa mga law enforcement agencies or especially sa mga police stations para ma-identify nila sino yung nagko-commit or sino yung suspect sa crime. So, pinapakita nila ito sa mga victim, then the victim will identify or pinpoint sino yung taong to o sino yung gumawa sa kanya ng crime. Mugshot. Ano mo itong mugshot? It is a photographic portrait taken after one is arrested. So, the standard operating procedure ng law enforcement or sa investigation, pag ma-aresto mo yung tao, siyempre, it will provide documentation. Then, ito yung mugshot. It's a photographic portrait taken after one is arrested. So, usually, itong mugshot, nilagay nito sa nilagay ng mga police station sa rogues gallery. Ito yung ginagamit nila na picture na nilagay nila sa rogues gallery, itong mugshot. So, dito tayo sa criminal investigation paper na discussion. Suppose tayo sa mga terms. Excuse. When we talk about criminal investigation, ito yung investigation mismo sa mga kriminal, diba? When we applied to law enforcement, it is safe to state that crimes cannot be solved on its own unless the police conducts criminal investigation. So ito yun. Criminal investigation daw is the systematic, meaning step by step process of determining whether or not a crime has been committed. So, may procedure na ginagamit ang mga police natin or yung mga law enforcement agencies when conducting a criminal investigation, di ba? Since it involves a step-by-step process, it helps to know the different stages involved in the development of a full-blown criminal investigation. So, ito yung mga different stages. First is the detection. When we talk about detection, it is the fact of discovery, meaning madi-discover mo yung suspect or madi-discover mo yung crime mismo na may crime talaga na na-commit. May crime talaga na nag-i-exist. So, ito yung detection. So, it is dito matitrigger ang operation ng criminal justice system. When we talk about criminal investigation, dito yun, dito ang pinakauna or the primary step ng criminal justice system natin. So, kung maliit lang na mali ang magawa ng criminal investigator natin or law enforcement agencies, so, same process. Parang kwan kasi yan eh. Parang chain or kadina. So kung ang kwan kasi ang first pillar ng criminal justice system natin is the law enforcement. So itong law enforcement, siyempre sila yung nag-enforce ng law, sila yung, din rin sila rin yung nagkakandak ng criminal investigation. So when they are conducting investigation in a wrong way or mali yung ginagawa nila, hindi nila na-detect ng maayos na may crime talaga na nag-exist. Siyempre, the whole pillars of criminal investigation magigiba. So, importante ang mga law enforcement officer is magawa nila ng maayos ang trabaho nila. Especially sa detection of crimes. Kasi ito yung first phase or ito yung first stage ng criminal investigation. The next is preliminary investigation. When we talk about preliminary investigation, it is the early or of initial stage of investigation, di ba? Immediately after the occurrence of the crime, after ma-detect. So ito yung pinakauna or initial investigation. So ito yung initial investigation na ginagawa ng law enforcement officer or investigator after the occurrence of the crime. Baka magda-doubt kayo sa preliminary investigation at sa CDI at sa LOA. Iba yung preliminary investigation na nandoon sa procedure o sa rules of court, at iba rin itong minimin or pinapaywatig ng preliminary investigation sa criminal detection investigation. So kung criminal detection investigation na questions ang sira nyo, siyempre kung may lalabas na preliminary investigation, ito yung step-by-step process na nasa fundamentals of criminal investigation. So kung mag-answer din kayo ng questions, kung doon kayo mag-answer sa law o sa criminal jurisprudence, siyempre ito yung 4 years, 2 months and 1 day na preliminary investigation na nandoon sa criminal procedure, sa rules of court. So iba yun na. So dito sa CDI, ang preliminary investigation is the initial investigation na ginagawa ng law enforcement or investigator after the occurrence of the crime. So third is the follow-up investigation. When we talk about follow-up investigation, ito yung after the initial investigation is being served, a more thorough o pinaigpit pang investigation ang gagawin ng law enforcement officer or investigator. So ito yung follow-up investigation. So sa preliminary investigation, nakalimutan ko, dito yung ma-involve yung trabaho ng first responder, di ba? Or mga patrol officers. Kasi sila yung mga frontliners sa criminal investigation. So sila yung pinaka first na makadetect na may crime, at sila yung makaresponde if ever na mag-occur na crime sa kanilang area of responsibility. So it involves also the coordinating of the crime scene, di ba? Sa first responder, in the gathering of information, so initial making of initial report. So nandito yun sa preliminary investigation. So follow-up investigation, sabi ko nga kanina, a thorough investigation is made by the investigator mismo. So after the preliminary investigation or the initial investigation of the law enforcement officer or the first responder or the patrol officer, so tatawag sila ng investigator. So ito na yung thorough investigation proper. Then proceed tayo dito sa re-investigation. So, in some cases na ma-encounter ng law enforcement officer or investigator, ito yung mga cases na kailangan i-reinvestigate. Bakit? Kasi may fatal errors are committed, di ba? In the earlier investigation. So, may mga technicalities na nakita sa investigation na mali yung ginawa ng mga frontliners or yung pinaka unang gumawa ng investigation, di ba? So, ito yung reinvestigation. This usually happens when unethical investigation practices are resorted to. Meaning, ito yung mga, for example, may tanting of evidence or investigation na ginawa yung reinforcement officer natin or mga investigator. So, dito, malaman yung reinvestigation. So, kung may tanting of evidence ba, yung may torture ba na ginawa, sa SOP ba nila o sa standard operating procedure nila ay may mali, wala bang Miranda rights na hindi ba nagbasa ng Miranda rights ang mga law enforcement officer? So dito natin malalaman sa re-investigation, diba? Sinabi ko na ito kasi na detection, the preliminary investigation, then the follow-up investigation. So, ito yung re-investigation. O, gaya nagsabi ko, yung pag-frame up, planting of evidence. So, ito yung mga ginagawa. So, kailangan i-re-investigate in order for the investigation na gumana, na hindi against sa law. So, kailangan tong i-correct. Kasi, when they are investigating a crime, sila yung mga mga nag-i-enforce ng law. So, if they are enforcing law, siyempre, kailangan hindi nila dapat i-break yung law. So, kailangan tong re-investigation to avoid itong mga torture, plantic evidence, investigation, frame up, or whitewash. Diba? So note, the criminal investigation in whatever stage is primarily repressive. Ano itong repressive? When we talk about repressive, meaning it comes into action only when a crime occurs. Meaning reactive. Diba? Kung, if we talk about criminal investigation, usually reactive to. Kasi hindi natin hindi tayo makakagawa ng criminal investigation pag wala pang crime, di ba? So, reactive to. Crime prevention is the first line of defense. Gaya ng sinabi ko, ito yung mga patrolling, di ba? Crime prevention to. But criminal investigation is the reactive. The second line of defense. So, baka labas to sa exam, at least alam nyo na investigation is the reactive or the second line of defense. So, this is the first part of the fundamentals of criminal investigation.